Hey, it's Gregor here. I have a new shop, just probably getting started from work tomorrow. Just need a Victor torch to start welding things. Anyways, I wanted to share a little different way to visualize energy. I'm currently experiencing a thunderstorm outside here in Asheville. And so, this is our hill that's covered with lots of kudzu, invasive plant. Drops off, it's all kudzu. So, anyways, the piece I wanted to share with you with the current weather situation, the thing about lightning and thunder is how equal and opposite reactions are working. Newton's most important laws, if we understand yin and yang. So, such as if there's a big bang, there has to also be a big collapse at the same time. So it's more like a big breath, rapid expansion, rapid contraction happening within the same moment. The rapid contraction gives birth to particles or eddy currents in the ether, and the rapid expansion, vacuum of space. So with lightning, right, how lightning works like a spark gap in a Tesla coil system. How to take advantage of that spark gap is when you have lightning, you have a discharge of two polarizations. Polarization of two different spaces, say the Earth and cloud. When that happens, you usually have negative lightning. The electrons are going down from the, or going from the Earth up into, or the clouds down into the Earth. That's the common type of lightning, negative lightning. So there's positive lightning. Positive lightning is where the electrons are going from the surface of the Earth up to the ionosphere. And they're much more powerful strikes, but not as common. Those are the strikes we're really tapping into with the Tesla Tower. Anyways, when that happens, when that moment happens, where you see this bolt of lightning strike down, something different going on than what we usually imagine. And so, you usually see this more vertical axis, when there's this horizontal piece taking place. And it relates to the electric magnetic field being perpendicular. So, Walter Russell, if you haven't read about Walter Russell, he's a phenomenal metaphysicist, one of the best metaphysicists, in my opinion, to ever walk on the face of the earth. He talks about yin and yang, the masculine force being centrifugal and expansive, and the feminine force being implosive, contractive, centripetal force. One's a spiraling out, one's a spiraling in. And when this is happening, you have space all around the lightning. And when you have a discharge of this energy through this space, it causes a rapid expansion and contraction of the space. This is the really important concept, is the expansion contraction of the ether. And the ether, for those who can't put their minds around it, it's a term no longer used. It's a balance point in space. It's an infinite, it's a structure of infinite density, and with no refraction or information applied to it in its natural static state. And it's everything around us polarizes that space. And so really, space is a cubic structure. It's the midpoint of the platonic solids is the cube. It's made of all 90 degree angles. Well, the other platonic solids are either concave or convex geometries, either focusing or refracting that information, that light in the system. And so, think of if you had no information applied to this space, it's just this cubic structure, and a lightning bolt fires through it, okay? The lightning bolt is the feminine force, it's the implosive contractive force, it's contracting into a very small, dense space. Just like you look up the night stars, night sky, you see the stars. The stars are this contractive light form, while space is this expansive dark form. The sometimes forget about the space. It's important in the system as well as the things that we're focusing on and everything else around it. And so when this happens, the electric aspect is contracting into this ray of light, essentially, this fractalizing ray of light. And it's becoming an extremely compressed form of energy. Energy spiraling in. The lightning itself would have a particular form, as around it, which is the magnetic form, the expansive form, expanding outwards from the contractive form. And that would be your thunder. That is the magnetic thrust outwards, the centrifugal thrust, as you have the rapid expansion and the rapid contraction taking place. And that causes, it's essentially causes a magnetic pressure wave. I mean, the whole magnetic electrical aspect of polarizing space has an acoustic relationship, a third dimensional relationship. As the actual, in my humble scientific opinion, that electrical and magnetic forces are aspects of the second dimension, and they interweave with third dimensional physics, and which is your acoustic properties, we generally talk about space and time. And you have that thunder, you have that boom. And so really the thunder can be related to the magnetic aspect, and the lightning to the electrical aspect. But really important to see the expansion and the contraction in space. People think of it more as the energy is moving from one spot to the next spot, okay? But that pathway is sort of the illusion in that you're having this space go boom all of a sudden. It just collapses in and snaps back out. It's an interesting thing. It's a very simple, interesting thing. And to go back to the idea of space and being a cubic geometry, it has to do with refraction of information. Reality is an information system. An information system, for the perception of a conscious entity to interact with. That's where we get into metaphysics, and some people would say, isn't science. But what's science without perspective? Ask you that. God, perceive it, to observe it, to then intellectualize it and put it to use, and sometimes just be with it. But refraction, simple things in physics that we don't talk about much anymore. Inertia, centrifugal force, torque. A linear force, we usually just call it a force. We call it gravity, it's really just one type of linear force. It's based on pressure. In its truest form, differentials in yin and yang. And refraction and reflection, those are really powerful things that have to do with radiance, angular momentum, angular projection. And that the qualitative aspect in dynamics is angular information over density or power of energy or voltage, strength, however you want to phrase it. It's like those games, if you ever played, like, you aim the cannon, you choose the angle, and you choose the power, and you fire it, and then you have a manifestation of this curve. Sometimes a spiral. Qualitative and quantitative information working together to create a system. Well, qualitative information, such as Gustavian vortex math, is angular information. And so, reflection and refraction. Refraction is something moving through a boundary layer, the fundamental boundary layer of reality. I'm going to go that way, because I just did. Is the infinitely thin boundary layer between the infinite and the finite. That's a fun one to talk about if you ever get into it. But when energy
vibration moves through a boundary layer, it can either reflect or refract. And the reflection is 180 degrees of the perspective, and the refraction is 180 degrees of the other perspective. And the refraction is where the energy moves through. So we call dielectrics, or insulative materials, non-conductive materials, that they don't absorb electromagnetic radiation. They're not really affected by it, or they're very weakly affected by it. That's because your dielectrics are all refracting the information. Well, it's your electrical conductors that reflect it. That's the big thing. An electrical conductor is a reflector, while the dielectrics are refractors. And so amperage is a result of not all of the energetic spectrum reflecting and highly refracting. And so superconductivity is a property of, it's a state of reflection, a complete state of reflecting. Just reflecting everything in the universe back to itself. So I think I end that by saying it's time for all of us to stop refracting and start reflecting. Because that's what we call the light workers. We just reflect all the beauty in the world outwards. And we refract ourselves back inwards. Well, it's been lovely talking, and things are moving forward in beautiful ways. And I hear something about August 4th. Ooh, that's interesting, huh? That's a dragon's blood, some Amazonian tree sap on the finger I sort of ripped open doing some fire dancing last night. No burns, just rubbing the skin away, you know. Adios, my friends. Have a good one. Namaste. And August 4th. We'll see. Bye.